So to compare controls, it is helpful to understand the general taxonomy of controls. A control is simply a defense or countermeasure put in place to manage what we call as risk, right? Risk. So if a risk cannot be completely avoided and transferred, but the organization is not willing to completely accept the risk, the most appropriate action is to mitigate the risk. Okay? Put it here. So controls can be classified in several ways, and some controls can apply across various types. At a high level, controls are classified as technical, managerial or management, and operational. Controls can be further classified by their functional use or according to the time period during which they are acted upon. For example, functionally they can be classified as deterrent, preventive, detective, or corrective controls. Now, you can apply this general classification of controls to mitigate risk, typically layering defensive controls to protect data with multiple control types. This technique is called a layered defensive strategy or defense in depth, right? Like DID, as we discussed from the previous chapters or section, right? Defense in depth. Now, let's dig deep on the three types of control. The first one is technical, of course. So here, the technical controls are security mechanisms that the specific systems run, either manually or more often automated and orchestrated. These controls deliver confidentiality, integrity, authenticity, and availability protections. They defend against unauthorized access or misuse. They also facilitate detection of security violations and support security requirements for applications and data. Now, some common technical controls would be infrastructure security, right, and device hardening, like for example, your firewalls and your IDS and IPS systems, right? And you also have identity and access management, or IAM, cryptographic key management and HSM, right? HSM is hardware security modules, right? And we also can implement web application firewalls, or WAF, and threat modeling tools and next generation endpoint protection and response. So in Cisco, they have what we call as AMP, right? That's their endpoint detection software. Now let's talk about managerial, right? So managerial controls are often referred to as administrative controls, right? Admin. It's very important that these types of controls are published or printed or documented in some definition of policies. And of course, policies are driven by governance, right? Whether you have a board of directors or a steering committee or your executive management, that's what's going to drive down the policies. So this would be things like how your company does risk assessment, right, and risk management, your best practices and guidelines, your password policies, and the procedures you go through for screening, right, background checks, hiring, and termination. So it could be things like dual operator principles or mandatory vacations and training and awareness programs. Okay. The third one is operational. So operational controls include organizational culture and physical controls that form the outer line of defense against direct access to data, such as protecting backup media or securing output in mobile file storage devices, and paying attention to facility design, right? And details, including layout, guards, locks, and surveillance system, right? All of this talks about physical controls. Now, next is this could also be a change of configuration management database that stores all of your CIs, right, or your configuration items. You can also conduct security awareness and training of your acceptable use policy and implementing physical and environmental controls, like for example, for heat and cold and humidity, fire detection and suppression, contingency planning, incident response, testing and drills, right? This could also include the system and data integrity mechanisms, like mobile device and application management, and disaster recovery plan testing and disaster recovery drills or exercises. Now let's talk about control types. The categories of controls that we just described earlier, right, is classified whether functional use or whether on the time when they are in use. So the following sections describe these controls, and we'll provide examples of each of them, right? So the list of control types here are deterrent, right, preventive, detective, and corrective. Now consider the importance of having both detection controls and prevention controls. In a perfect world, right, we would need only prevention controls. Unfortunately, that not all malicious activity can be prevented. As a result, it is important to make detection controls as part of a layered security approach. For example, the best protected banks use both detective controls and preventive controls. In addition to the locks, bars, and security signs, the bank probably has various detective controls, such as motion detectors and cash register audits. Now, controls work together as a security system and provide layered defense mechanisms for defense in depth, or DID. Now, let's dig deep on each of this one, right? So the first one is deterrent. So deterrent controls are intended to discourage individuals from intentionally violating information security policies or procedures. Now, deterrents do not necessarily have to be designed to stop unauthorized access. And as the name implies, these controls need to help deter access. They usually take the form of a punishment or consequence that makes performing unauthorized activities desirable. Deterrence involves detecting violations that are attached to some form of punishment that the intruder fears. Examples of deterrent controls are warnings indicating that systems are being monitored. Perhaps you have seen or know someone who has a beware of dog sign but doesn't actually have a dog. Next is preventive. Preventive controls attempt to prevent unwanted events by inhibiting the free use of computing resources. Preventive controls are often hard for users to accept because they restrict free use of resources. Examples of preventive administrative controls include security awareness, separation of duties, access controls, security policies and procedures, intrusion prevention system, firewalls, and anti-malware. Next are detective controls. Detective controls attempt to identify unwanted events after they have occurred. Common technical detective controls include audit trails, intrusion detection systems, system monitoring, checksums, and anti-malware. Common physical detective controls include motion detectors, CCTV monitors, and alarms, right? Administrative detective controls are used to determine compliance with security policies and procedures. They can include security reviews and audits, mandatory vacations, and rotation of duties. And the last type is corrective. So, corrective controls are reactive, right, and provide measures to reduce harmful effects or restore the system that is being affected. So, examples of corrective controls include operating system upgrades, data backup restoration, vulnerability mitigation, and anti-malware. Now let's talk about compensating controls. Compensating controls are alternative controls that are intended to reduce the risk of an existing or potential control weakness. Compensating controls are not a shortcut to compliance or security. They come into play when a business or technological constraint exists and an effective alternate control is used in the current security threat landscape. For example, if a separation of duties is required but duties cannot be separated because of company size, compensating controls should be in place. They can include audit trails and transaction logs that someone in a higher position reviews. Now, we need to look no further than our daily lives to find examples and analyses of the various types of controls and compensating controls that we encounter every day. In your digital life, you might have met someone who doesn't want to incur the cost, right, like monetary or perceived technical, of running anti-malware software. Now, that person might compensate, like for example, by being extra careful and navigating to only well-known trusted websites. Also consider the following examples here. So in order to prevent unwanted network access, right, in the wired network, the compensating control is to simply disable the unused switchboards. To also segregate to ensure the segregation of duties is followed, a video surveillance can be the compensating control here. Now, to be able to ensure multi-factor authentication for each application, we can implement network access control with multi-factor authentication. Right? That's the end of the lesson. In this lesson, we spoke about control categories, control types, and the compensating controls. Thank you for watching the video.